Hello and welcome to the Ditto educational series that will provide you with the skills you need to become a Forex trader. On today's episode, we will be discussing and introducing Elliott Wave Theory. Elliott Wave Theory was developed by Ralph Nelson Elliott in the 1930s. Elliott believed that markets generally did not behave randomly and in fact traded in repetitive patterns. Let's now take a look into Elliott Wave Theory and how it is applied to the Forex market. Elliott theorized that trends in financial prices resulted from market participant psychology. He found that swings in mass psychology always relayed themselves in reoccurring fractal patterns or waves in the financial markets. Elliott's theories resemble another theory we will talk about in future known as the Dow theory. Both theories recognize that prices move in waves. Elliott, however, additionally recognized that the market had a fractal nature. Fractals, which we have discussed previously, are mathematical structures. On a small enough scale, they infinitely repeat themselves. Elliott identified that price patterns were also structured the same way. From this, he then tried to find a way that his repeating patterns could be used as a leading or predictive indicator. Elliott derived detailed stock market predictions based upon the reliable characteristics he discovered in the wave patterns. In this example, we have an impulse wave. It travels in the same direction as the larger trend, and there are always five waves within the pattern. Next, we have a corrective wave. This travels in the opposite direction of the main trend. Within the Forex market, where the price moves up or down, it is always followed by a correction or a opposite movement. Trends show the main direction of prices, while corrections move against the trend. These examples are two waves that represent both movements. Let's now take a closer look into the impulse and correction waves. The impulse wave has five waves moving in the direction of the overall trend. This is followed by three waves moving in a correction against the trend. This is two waves made up of five and three moves. They then become the two subdivisions of the next higher wave move. Look at the following example made of the eight total waves we have discussed. The impulse wave labeled 1 to 5 and the correction wave labeled A to C. The 5-wave impulse will in turn go on to form wave 1 at the next largest degree, and the 3-wave correction will go on to form wave 2 at the next largest degree. The properties of the corrective wave normally have three distinct price movements. Two of the movements are usually in the direction of the correction. These are countertrend, and one move will travel in the direction of the trend. Similarly, in waves 2 and 4 of the impulse wave, these are corrections against the trend. So to summarize this information so far, waves are formed by the market movements. They are defined by their behavior. The entirety of an impulse wave and the correction wave together can form the beginning of a larger degree wave. How do we know we are seeing a wave in progress? As always, there are rules to the identification of waves. The impulse wave. Wave 1. Wave 1 is not always apparent at first. When the first wave of a new bullish market begins, fundamental and technical outlook is usually entirely negative. The previous trend has not given us enough information to consider that it is about to reverse. Sentiment is usually still bearish at this point, and remember, Elliott wave is rooted in psychology. Wave 2. Wave 2 is the correction of wave 1. It can never extend beyond the beginning of wave 1 or it becomes invalid. Prices retest the previous low. Bearish sentiment can quickly increase as people anticipate the downtrend may continue. However, volume is generally lower than seen in wave 1. If we were to measure the retracement, it's very common that it doesn't go beyond the 61.8% level when using a Fibonacci retracement tool. Wave 3. Wave 3 is usually the largest movement in the wave in a trend and can generate the largest yield in pips. This can vary in different markets, such as commodities, where wave 5 is sometimes the largest. The fundamentals now are more positive and prices begin to rise quickly. Smaller corrections usually are short-lived and shallow, and opportunity to now get involved on a pullback is limited. It is often at the midpoint of wave 3 that the market participants begin to change their sentiment and heavily get involved in the buy side. The bullish trend is now becoming certain. Wave 3 often extends beyond wave 1 by a ratio of 1.618 to 1. Fibonacci shows its hand again. Wave 4. Wave 4 is the second corrective move. Prices may stall and move sideways for an extended period. Wave 4 typically retraces less than 38.2% of wave 3. We see volume levels well below that of wave 3. This can be a good opportunity to buy in the pullback when expecting the potential rise for wave 5. Wave 5 is the last phase in the direction of the now dominant trend. News is almost universally positive and bullish outlook is almost universal. Volume is often lower in wave 5 than wave 3, and we begin to see divergence on momentum indicators. Despite market participants still entering buys, the move is now complete and the correction wave is anticipated. The correction. Wave A. Corrections are generally harder to identify than impulse moves. In wave A of a bear market, the fundamental news is still positive. The behavior seen is similar to that of the beginning of wave 1. We may see increased volume and possibly a turn higher in open interest. Our video explaining open interest is a very good lesson in regards to this. Wave B is the correction. Prices reverse higher. Some participants will see this as a resumption of the bull market. Technical analysts may see the peak as the right shoulder of the head and shoulders reversal pattern. Fundamentals are probably getting worse at this point, but not entirely negative, and volume during wave B should be lower than in wave A. Wave C. Prices move steadily lower, volume increases, and the bear market is now confirmed. Wave C is typically at least as large as wave A and often extends to 1.618 times wave A or beyond. Elliott wave theory is a complex and expansive subject that we will look into continue teaching in future. This introduction to the theory is just the tip of the iceberg in terms of what there is to know. Please contemplate what you have learned here today, and remember, contemplation is the key to learning. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed our educational sessions, then please like and subscribe.